Evil Dead Trap is a Japanese horror film from 1988. In some cases, just knowing what decade a movie was made in can sometimes give audiences a pretty good idea of what to expect, and Evil Dead Trap is certainly a good example of this, because the film shares a lot of similarities to other horror movies that were made in the 1980s, right down to the cheesy, reoccurring theme music. So for fans of 80s slasher films, I think those people will find a lot to like here. But I'd even go a little bit further and say that anyone who's looking for an entertaining slasher film will probably have a good time with this movie. And just for fans of Japanese horror films in general, I think this movie can be enjoyable because even though it does have some horror movie cliches, it doesn't have the modern Japanese horror movie staples like ghosts with long black hair. So I think the experience can end up still feeling fresh. Evil Dead Trap is just a lot of fun. Evil Dead Trap's plot revolves around the story of Nami, the host of a local television program who is sent in a videotape from a viewer. The tape appears to be a snuff film as it shows the gruesome murder of a woman. Nami and her production crew decide to investigate the location where it appears that the video was recorded. And as they investigate this abandoned factory, they are stalked and begin to be murdered by a mysterious stranger. And from here it becomes a desperate struggle for survival as the production crew attempts to escape from this terrifying nightmare. Probably one of the best aspects of this movie was how quickly it began to provide viewers with suspenseful and scary moments. I think it's safe to say that people going into a slasher movie are expecting some intense and heart-pounding scenes, and within the first 10 minutes of the movie, the main characters are already at the abandoned factory where all of the murders take place. Clearly, this isn't the type of movie that wants to make audiences wait upwards of 50 to 60 minutes before anything noteworthy happens. In fact, a murder scene occurs even before the characters make it to this factory, so that's not even 10 minutes into the film that killing is already occurring. While this is a truly great thing, audiences aren't exactly going to be surprised by a lot of what the film is throwing at them early on. Watching the main characters split up and walk around this abandoned factory is clearly something that horror movie fanatics will have seen a million times before. It's very clear that someone is watching these people, and us as the audience just know that bad things are going to happen, and the characters are going to get murdered one by one. But I don't really think this is much of a negative, because I doubt people going into a slasher movie are expecting a truly unique and original experience. Instead, I believe people are more interested in seeing the kills themselves. And in that category, Evil Dead Trap doesn't do too badly. While there are only 5 people who journey into this abandoned factory, the people do begin to get murdered in different ways. This film doesn't repeat the same sort of death sequences twice, and each kill is definitely unique. Just like most slasher films, though, it's hardly a realistic experience, but depending on your mindset going into the movie, this may help to make the film more fun. After convincing yourself that things aren't always going to be realistic, it's an absolute blast to just sit back and enjoy the wild ride that the film takes you on. While I thought that the film did a good job at continually providing audiences with some creative death scenes and suspenseful moments to watch for the first 2/3 of the film, I thought that things really did begin to change as the movie reached its climax. The film begins to explain more about the killer, and as more details are revealed, things just get stranger and stranger. I don't want to say that the film is necessarily dragging on too much, but it did really get to the point where I was like, it's over now. Okay, now it has to be over. Oh my gosh, it's still not over yet? So don't get me wrong, I like how the film wanted to keep me guessing. It's just a little bit of a departure from the straightforward murder sequences that overpowered the first 2/3 of the movie, so it takes a little bit of adjusting to get used to. So that's the only thing I see people possibly having a problem with. Some viewers may like how the film begins to show its weird Japanese roots as the experience begins to approach its end, while others may have been happy if it was just indeed a ruthless, nameless killer behind all of the murders. For me, I enjoyed how the film slightly changed as it reached its conclusion. It certainly helped to make the movie a memorable one. The Region 1 DVD release of Evil Dead Trap comes from Synapse Films. Besides the movie itself, the DVD contains the film's trailer as well as a commentary track featuring the special effects manager and the director of the film. It's too bad that there isn't a behind-the-scenes feature that has some interviews from the cast, but the commentary does contain some interesting moments. The problem with the commentary, though, is that the people who are talking really do have thick accents that are very hard to understand. But Synapse Films did mention this in an insert that comes with the DVD, and I'm still glad they decided to include this commentary track, because it was very neat to hear the effects manager and the director talk about some of the scenes. It was interesting to hear the effects manager say that he has been asked by some North American effects people about some of the techniques that he used within the film.
For me, Evil Dead Trap ended up making all the right moves to ensure that I remained engaged in the experience for the film's entire duration. While I think it certainly will appeal to most people who enjoy horror films from the 80s, I think it ends up being a good balance of both extreme and mainstream horror movies, which will help to keep a wider audience of viewers interested. The film definitely doesn't shy away from showing nudity and violence, but it just never gets to the point where it's completely gruesome, you know, where people would want to turn off the movie in disgust, for example. Actually, the movie even contains several moments where it shines stylistically, as the use of color here is just fantastic. There are several scenes where blue lighting is used effectively, and there are a number of other scenes where it seems like everything has a bright yellow glow, which looks really neat. So people looking for a complex, thought-provoking horror film won't find a lot to like here, but for everyone else, I think this movie deserves to be watched. Evil Dead Trap is entertaining and a whole lot of fun.